Hi guys, Robin and Laura from nzpocketguide.com here, and today we're going to be talking about how to keep warm when camping in New Zealand. All right, guys, we're going to go through some very quick and handy tips on how to keep warm when camping in New Zealand. Because, yeah, it's camping is awesome in New Zealand. It's really good way to connect with nature and experience the great outdoors, which is kind of what New Zealand is known for with all its beautiful scenery. However, on an evening when you are sort of camping in a tent or even in a camper van, sometimes it can be pretty chilly and pretty cold, so it's really important to, in order to have a nice comfortable night's sleep, to know a few ways to keep warm while you're camping. So let's kick off this list with the first tip. Do you have the first tip, Robin?
Yes, that's pretty simple. Check out the weather. Make sure that you check the weather before you go camping and you pack accordingly. If you do know that it's going to be quite rainy, quite muddy and all that, make sure that you do have some polypropylene layers or some wool or merino wool layers that will help you keep warm even if you are a little bit wet. Check the weather, super important.
Yeah, the next tip is to eat hot food. So eating hot food helps keep your core body temperature nice and warm and sort of releases energy slowly and stuff. So that's really important. And then for camping, because you can't really light a fire anywhere in New Zealand, it's a really good idea to actually have your own sort of camping stove and take that with you so you can not only boil water and stuff if you need to have more water and it's to be safe to drink, but also to heat up a nice warm meal and have that before going to bed. So that's a really good way to keep warm while camping.
All right, next tip is going to be a quick one. Go to the toilet before you go to bed. So if you're about to zip yourself into your sleeping bag, make sure you go to the toilet beforehand so you don't have to move during the night and cool down a lot, because your sleeping bag is going to cool down, your tent is going to cool down because you're going to have to open it, and you will cool down. So make sure that you go to the toilet before you go to bed.
All right, next on the list is get yourself some portable heated camping gear. Now, there are some really awesome sort of heating camping gear products out there right now. We have just done a review for Outchair, so if you guys want to go check out that video on the channel, Outchair is a brand that make these sort of heated camping products, and they do sort of electric blankets that you can take into your tent. I mean, how sort of luxurious is that? And it's
flashbacking / glamping.
It is, and they also do sort of portable camping chairs as well, and also these really cool sort of heat pads, which is just it's powered by a small power bank and it's using sort of infrared technology. Yeah, just check out the review to see what all that is about, but yeah, I really recommend using those to keep yourself warm while camping.
All right, so this is a bit more of a nifty little trick right here. But if you do put your clothes inside the bottom of your camper, sleeping bag, when you are going to bed, your body heat will hit your clothes for tomorrow already. So when you have to put them on in the crispy morning, then they are already going to be warm, and that's just going to be delicious to put on.
Oh,
yes. Yes. So yeah, that's a trick that actually I got from a German guy during my first year backpacking around New Zealand. And you know what? It changed my life. So I just want to say hi to Hans. Thank you so much for this one, man. All right. Moving on.
Another tip I would give is use a hot water bottle and put it in your sleeping bag as well. So if you're camping, this is more if you're not sort of hiking camping, you don't really want to be packing that extra gear. But if you're camping and you have a car and you can have all that extra gear, then a hot water bottle is super useful. If you just need to boil some water and then put it in and put that into your sleeping bag, and then you have a little cocoon of warmth and it lasts pretty much all night. So yeah, do that.
All right, we're going to stick with the sleeping bag tips, and you can sleep with your phone in your sleeping bag. I cannot say sleeping bag today. Anyway, if you sleep in your sleeping bag with your phone first, the phones usually heat a little bit, so that's going to heat your sleeping bag, which is quite nice. But also, the cold usually drains batteries way faster. So it's something to know. You will lose your battery of the phone really, really fast in winter in New Zealand because it's that cold. So in order for it to last a little bit longer, let's say you're on a multi-day trip or any of that, either obviously turn it off if you don't have any receptions, but if you want it to stay on, you may put it inside your sleeping bag and keep it warm. We did that quite a lot during filming of New Zealand's biggest gap year when we're traveling in camper van around New Zealand. We actually usually took also, I just got distracted by a native bird over there. We did that quite a lot. We usually took them with us into the accommodation, not leaving it in the camper van. Or sometimes when we were sleeping in the camper van, we kept it with us in the section where we were sleeping in order to keep the batteries from draining and being able to film all the stuff we wanted to film for you guys. So here you go.
Okay, our final tip, also to do with batteries and power, is choose lithium batteries over alkaline batteries, because lithium is more designed for, it can deal with the cold better. Alkaline will just drain. So if you've got any torches or like headlights or anything that you need to put batteries in, then just keep that in mind. So yeah, that's all our tips. Do you want to wrap it up, Robin?
Yes, so if you guys like what we do, make sure to click the like button. It's a great free way for you guys to support all our hard work. If you don't like what we do, you see a button that looks like that, don't click on it.
You can if you want.
Okay, you can also subscribe. We get plenty of tips for you for traveling around New Zealand. We're literally about to wrap that up as we are at the end of our walk. That's perfect.
Yeah.
So you can hit subscribe. It's a great way to get all our travel tips. And you can check out nzpocketguide.com. So it's www.nzpocketguide.com. It is New Zealand's largest travel guide, and it's entirely free for you to use. So check it out and enjoy your trip in New Zealand. We've got plenty more tips coming your way really soon. Bye-bye.
See ya.